Hello everyone, welcome to the 9th session on AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner Crash Course. In this session, we are going to discuss about various management and governance tools which are provided by AWS. This session is quite interesting thing to know in terms of various monitoring stuff. So, first thing to know is all about AWS CloudWatch. AWS CloudWatch is the monitoring and observatory service which is provided by AWS. People who are working with AWS know CloudWatch very well. CloudWatch is more of a monitoring service which provides the insights, which provides the various different parameters related to different AWS resources. Say for example, I want to know the performance of my EC2 machine. You can very well install the CloudWatch agents on the EC2 machine, and based on the methodology which we are installing, it will send the logs to CloudWatch in either 1 minute or 5 minute or like that. So we can see the metrics over there. We can analyze all the details of the EC2 machine using the AWS CloudWatch metrics. So how the AWS CloudWatch works? So here you can see CloudWatch will provide the complete visibility of all your applications. It collects the details, as we already discussed. It collects the details, it collects the various different metrics and provides a visualizing dashboard where we can see the performance and all these things. Once that is done, you can do the actionable insights as well using the CloudWatch alarms. Say if my CPU threshold is going beyond some limit, then what I can create is a CloudWatch alarm. That CloudWatch alarm will trigger an event. That event will be integrated with other services like SNS to send the notification, to send an email, something like that. So all these types of options are done using CloudWatch. In general terms, CloudWatch is all about monitoring the performance of various AWS resources. The next thing in the category is AWS CloudTrail. Some confusing stuff people used to confuse between CloudWatch and CloudTrail. What is the exact difference between CloudWatch and CloudTrail? CloudWatch is all about the performance of the resources within AWS. CloudTrail is all about monitoring the API activity. CloudWatch is at resource level, CloudTrail is at account level. So it is used for auditing, for any of the auditing purpose, and to monitor the account level activity, to monitor the API level activity, CloudTrail is used. CloudTrail is very well integrated with S3, so we can send the CloudTrails to S3 bucket, and from there we can do the analysis using an native SQL tools like Athena, or else we can analyze that logs using CloudWatch metrics as well. So CloudTrail and CloudWatch are the closest neighbors which we need to know as the part of the monitoring stuff. Coming to other options, we need to know about AWS Config. AWS Config is the configuration service which helps us to create, which helps us to notify us when there is a configuration changes happens in my AWS ecosystem. Simple example to understand this, say I am having an EC2 machine, I had created a security group for the EC2 machine. I want to be notified, I want to know if there is a security group change happened on that EC2. That can be done using the config. Config comes with pre-built rules. There are a lot of pre-built managed rules within the config. We can define the custom rules as well. So for it can be integrated again with CloudTrail and SSM and load balancer and AWS organizations to have a holistic view on any of the configuration changes. We can very well make use of the AWS config. The next stuff in the category is AWS CloudFormation. CloudFormation is close to people who are working on DevOps. It is all about infrastructure as code. In very simple terms, it can be used to deploy the AWS infrastructure using code. Code can be written in YAML or JSON. So we need to place the code on S3 bucket, and then using the code which we wrote, we can spin up the infrastructure within minutes. So it's simple to use, just a complete code, whatever the infrastructure which we are going to deploy, say whatever the AWS resources which we are going to deploy on top of AWS ecosystem, it can be done using AWS CloudFormation by writing simple code. this is some interesting stuff. AWS personal health dashboard. Is there any place where I can find the details about the current health status of AWS resources? AWS offers something called AWS personal health dashboard. In this dashboard, this looks like that. In this dashboard, you can see, say, if there is some scheduled changes which is going to happen, or is there is any open issues happened on your account, even at the AWS level. Say, if you want to know the status of the AWS services, if you want to know any outage on any of the AWS services, all these details can be viewed using the AWS personal health dashboard. And another important thing to remember is the AWS OpsWorks. OpsWorks is all about the configuration management. It is again another DevOps related concept. So if you are working with DevOps, configuration management tools are very, very important. Major configuration management tools available in the market right now are open source Chef and Puppet. So OpsWorks closely works with Chef and Puppet. If you are already having your workloads running on Chef and Puppet, we can very well migrate that workloads to AWS OpsWorks. AWS OpsWorks holds its own proprietary called AWS OpsWorks stacks, where you can define your own configuration management workloads. Coming to the next one, it is the AWS Systems Manager. AWS Systems Manager is the operations hub within the AWS, which means it holds lot of things. There are lot of things available to us in Service Systems Manager. It's a unified user experience where you can track and resolve your operational issues. So what are all the tasks which I can do on Systems Manager? So let's consider an example. I am having a fleet of 100 EC2 instances. I need to run, say I need to upgrade something, I need to run some sort of a command onto all the set of EC2 instances. One bad way of doing that is to logging in into all the EC2 and doing that. But the AWS provides a lot of other options. One option is AWS Systems Manager run command. Using this run command, you can specify your targets. It is going to be in fleet of EC2. So it will run the run command on all the fleet of EC2 instances. So similar ways, there are a lot of options there. Yeah, SSM parameter store is one place where we can store all the secrets and all. As we discussed in the previous video, secrets manager and parameter store are the two options. If in case of key rotation and management of rotation policies, then secrets manager is the ideal place to store your secrets. So parameter store is one option to store the secrets. Run command, which we already discussed. We can define the maintenance windows for our database workloads. Say I want to have the database patch which needs to happen at specific point in time. So we can define those type of maintenance windows as well. There are a lot of other options also available with Systems Manager. So Systems Manager is the holistic place where we can completely manage our operations. Important thing to remember as the part of the exam is AWS Trusted Advisor. Trusted Advisor is the kind of the advisor tool which provides various different advices on security, performance and other cost optimization as well. We need to remember these five things. This Trusted Advisor screen looks like this. It provides the cost optimization. It provides the details on performance, security, fault tolerance and service limits. So you can see this, right? The green tick marks are the good ones, and the exclamation marks is all about warnings. So the red ones is all about immediate attention. So all these details are provided to us using AWS Trusted Advisor. Final thing in this category to remember is AWS organizations. AWS organizations is a quite broader topic to understand. But in simple terms, it is all about managing multiple accounts within the AWS ecosystem. So I am going to have, in typically if you see, enterprises will be having multiple AWS accounts. So to manage multiple AWS accounts together, to create a sub account within the AWS account. So all these types built to us organizations. So it is mainly used to scale your workloads, scale your workloads, and it provides the custom environments for different types of workloads, and it simplifies the permission management using something called as an SCPs, which is the service control policies. So service control policies will be having the higher priority. So we can define various different policies. It is like access related stuff. We can deny the access, we can grant the accesses using the service control policies, and it is like we can efficiently provision the resources across across multiple different accounts, we need to know something on cost optimization. Organizations provide something called as a consolidated billing feature, which will provide more cost optimization. Instead of creating multiple accounts and getting multiple bills for different accounts, we can have AWS organizations where we can have a single bill for all the AWS usage. And since we are going to use multiple things within the same account, in the bill we will be getting a lot of discounts. So consolidated billing is one good option to remember in terms of the cost optimization. The all features is the another feature of organizations which needs to be enabled in order to apply the service control policies to the AWS organizations. So how the AWS organizations works, it's very simple. You can create an account, once you create the organizations, you can add the accounts to that organizations, and then you can group the accounts together, and we can apply the policies. As I mentioned, using the service control policies, we can apply the policies and we can enable various different AWS services using AWS organizations. We came to end of this lecture. I hope this lecture is informative for you. I am looking forward to see you in the next lecture.